So at some point as a data analyst, whether you're working in a company, whether you're working as a freelancer, or whether you're working as owner of a data analytics consultancy, you're going to be running a data project. Okay, so this could be anything from like building a predictive model, answering some particular business question, building a dashboard, whatever it is, you'll be asked to do something. Okay, and you're going to have to own that project. Now, there are certain key features that you have to do in a data project plan. Now, the detail may vary from project to project, but in my experience, there are some key features that you have to do in order to make sure that the project is successful. So the first thing is that you have to define the business problem. So what you have to do here is make sure that you take the brief from the client and replay it back to them. Tell them what you understand that they want to do. And if the client goes, yeah, that's exactly what I want to do, then great, you've understood it. But if they go, no, actually, I meant this, then you know that you haven't understood it properly, or they haven't articulated it properly. Now, how you understand or define the business problem, you can do it over email, you can do it face-to-face, you can even do it in a kickoff meeting where you sort of bring your team, they bring their, bring all the stakeholders who are part of this project, and you replay what you think the business problem is and how you're going to solve it. If you cannot define the business problem, if the business can't define the business problem, or your stakeholders can't define the business problem, then you're going to have trouble later on. It doesn't matter what you do, you won't be answering the question. So make sure that you all understand, that everybody involved in the project understand what it is that you're trying to achieve. So that's number one. Then the next thing to do is to have a plan how you're going to access the data. Is it going to be a one-off extract? Is it going to be connection to a database? Are they going to give you a login for you to then extract the data yourself or connect to the data yourself? What is the process going to be? You've got to put that into your project plan. Now, generally, people said, well, that only takes a day, takes an hour, whatever. Trust me, it doesn't. Okay, sometimes you're lucky, and yes, you know, if you work with a client before, or if you work with a data source before, you can access it immediately and download the data or connect to it and start your analysis. But what I do in the project plan is usually allow between 5 to 10 working days. Now, the reason for that is it's not just access to the data, is finding who can give you access, getting the logins, getting, you know, the access to the system, getting that data. So there could be lots of steps in there. So allow yourself between 5 and 10 working days to get access to the data. Now, if you build that into your project plan, then the expectations are met on both sides. Because what you don't want to say is that we'll have the kickoff meeting, define the business problem, get access to the data next day, and start at the analysis. And if after a week you haven't still started the analysis, the business will be like, well, what's going on? I thought you would have something by now. So make sure you factor in about, like I said, 5 to 10 days. I generally put in 10 days in the project plan to access the data. People ask me, well, that's a long time. I say, look, trust me, from my experience, even just finding or even getting access, like going through all the approvals to get an email or a login, can take up to a week, 2 weeks. The next thing is, once you've got access to the data, is that you look at the data. Now, sometimes if you're given extracts, you might find that you're given multiple tables, so you've got to join them, you've got to clean the data, you've got to transform the data. There's lots of things to do. Even if you have direct access to the system, you've got to make sure that you know which tables you're meant to be using, make sure that you have access to the right level of data that you need, the right granularity. So, you know, having data preparation in your project plan is very key. So you should factor that in. Again, it shouldn't take that long. I usually put between 2 to 5 days in there for data preparation. You can put slightly longer, but don't expect it to be quicker than 2 days. Once you've got all the data preparation done, the next stage is then to do an exploratory data analysis. Now, this may seem redundant. Why do one? Why not go straight into the analysis? The reason you do an exploratory data analysis, especially if you don't aren't familiar with the data, is to understand that what the data you're seeing, that you could play it back to the business and they understand the findings. Now, what I mean here is, let's say you're looking at transactional data and you go, actually, in the month of June, July, August, these were the number of transactions. So you would play it back to the business and say, look, these are what I found as the number of transactions in these months. Do you also see those in your existing report? Because they do see it in the existing report and it matches more or less. I mean, sometimes it won't be 100%, but if it matches more or less, I'm talking about 99% match, 98% match, then you're fine. You've analyzed the data, or you understood the data correctly, and you're able to replicate their existing report. But sometimes you find that they've got some business logic, or they've got some filter somewhere, or they do some calculation somewhere that you're not aware of, and so therefore your numbers don't match their numbers. And so therefore, if you were to do the analysis on those numbers, it would be wrong, because it doesn't match what the business is. So the exploratory data analysis really to make sure that the numbers that you are working with match the numbers or the outputs that the business is used to seeing. Because the last thing you want to do is say, look, I've done an analysis, I've built a dashboard, or I've built a model, and this is what I predicted in the business, because actually we don't have that many customers, or we know we don't have that many transactions, or we have double that many transactions. You know, if suddenly those base numbers aren't correct, then the analysis won't be correct. So exploratory data analysis is a key feature of a business plan, of a project plan. And again, I'd factor in about 2 weeks, 10 working days to do that. So once you've done the exploratory data analysis and you've matched the base numbers that you're working with, then you go and run your analysis. And whether that analysis results in a dashboard, a predictive model, or something else, you just go off and do that. Now, it depends on the project, depends on that. That is a bespoke timeline. Now, if I'm running something like a churn model or some kind of predictive model or propensity model, I typically try and factor in about 4 to 8 weeks in those projects. So you can usually work out based on what exactly the client wants, how much time you'll need. So you just need to work that out yourself. In the past, how long it took you to build a dashboard, how long it took to build a predictive model, you just factor that in. So that part of the business, as part of the project plan, is dependent on what exactly the business wants. And you should have an idea of that because you would have built those kind of things in the past. So once you've run the explorative data analysis, the next thing you want to do is just before you're about to finish, so something like the final draft of your dashboard or your analysis or your model or predictive model or whatever it is that you're doing, you want to present it to the business. Now, what I wouldn't do is wait until the final element, because you may have baked certain things in and the business is like, well, I don't want that. It takes a lot of time to rework it. You don't want to present it too early because there'll be certain things that you'll be doing anyway, and the client might say, why don't you do this, why don't you do that? And you were going to do it anyway. So what you want to do is present it almost finished, but like a final draft, so that you've still got flexibility to change it and then take the feedback from the client and then be able to finalize it. Generally, what I do when I run through the analysis or the final draft of the analysis, or my team does, is we try and do it face to face. That way you can sort of demonstrate the product. And some of the analysis you can't actually just hand over, like a predictive model, a churn model, you can't just hand it over for them to critique. You've got to walk them through what the findings mean, how it's going to be used by the business, and what they're going to do with it. So try and do it face to face and factor that in. So what I normally do is at the beginning, if I know that the analysis is going to take 4 weeks, then within like a week into the analysis, 3 weeks in advance, I'll try and get the meeting in the diary. It also then gives you a deadline to meet. Otherwise, you could procrastinate on building the model, or try and tweak it and finesse it to get it perfect and waste a lot of time. So getting that in the diary, getting that running through the analysis, the final draft in the diary, gives you a good deadline. Then once you've got the feedback, you can then build the final model or the final dashboard or whatever it is. So once you've got the feedback and you've built the final product, you want to then hand it over to the client and say, this is the final product and it's finished, or to your stakeholder. But what you don't want to do is just send it over an email, say, look, here's the final dashboard, here's the link to it, or the predictive model has been built and, you know, I've uploaded the scoring into the database or the CRM system or whatever it is. You actually want a handover session. Now, the reason I always ask for a handover session with a client, because it finalizes the delivery. Because what normally might happen is that you send a link and say, here's the dashboard, and the client goes, oh, I got more feedback. Or you might say, you know, we've uploaded the model, and they may never use it, or they may not know how to use it. So doing a handover session means that you can actually formally say, look, we are handing over the project to you. It's finished. Any other changes, anything else, becomes a new project, and you start the cycle again. So what you don't end up doing is going into a continuous loop of a project that never ends, okay? By doing the handover session, you have a discrete moment where you say the project is finished and it's handed over. So those are the key sort of must-have features of a data analytics project. So like I said, just to recap, define the business problem, make sure you put in time to access the data, make sure you do some data, you know, have time for data preparation, do an exploratory data analysis. Obviously, you then run the analysis, and when you get to a final draft, have a feedback session with a client so that you can get any final feedback, finalize the product, and then do a handover session to actually finalize the project. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do like and share the video, and keep watching for more videos that I'll be publishing soon.